Namaskar students, once again I'm here with another video on respiration. Let's start with respiration in plants. In plants, every part such as leaves, stems and root respires. Exchange of respiration or the respiratory gases in plant takes place by the process of diffusion. At night, when photosynthesis does not occur, carbon dioxide elimination occurs as the major activity. During the day, carbon dioxide generated during respiration is used up for photosynthesis. Hence, there is no release of carbon dioxide. Instead, release of oxygen is the major event during the day. Now, one thing we have to keep in the mind that the respiration takes place during both day and night at a constant rate. Okay, now first we'll see the plant part, that is the root. How does root respire? Okay, the root of a plant are fixed in the soil, that we all know. The fine air spaces you can see over here in between the molecules of the soil, there are these spaces present, that is called the air spaces. Okay, so the fine air spaces present in between the soil particles contains oxygen. This oxygen is taken up by the root hair through diffusion to epidermal cells of the root. Similarly, carbon dioxide from the epidermal cells of the root moves back into air spaces in the soil through root hair. If we are talking about the stem, as we all know, the small plants like herbs have the green tender stem and they contain stomata. So, the exchange of gases in those plants takes place through the stomata. But in the woody plants, the stem covered with bark. And on the bark, there are small openings are present. They are called lenticels. So, exchange of gases in tall plants or the trees occurs between stem and the atmosphere through the lenticels. Now, respiration in leaves. In the previous videos only we have discussed about the stomata and the structure and function of the stomata. Now, here how it is helping in the respiration, let's check out it. The exchange of respiratory gases in leaves takes place through stomata by the process of diffusion. Oxygen diffuses in through the stomata and reaches the leaf cells. And carbon dioxide diffuses out of the leaf cells. When carbon dioxide concentration is in the cells increases, the stomata opens and carbon dioxide is released into the atmosphere. After plants, let's see about exchange of gases in animals. Okay. Now, different animals have different organs for the uptake of oxygen from the atmosphere and release of carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. Terrestrial animals can breathe in oxygen from the atmosphere, whereas aquatic animals breathe in oxygen dissolved in water. All the respiratory organs used by different organisms possesses the following characteristics. Students, very important, you should know all these three characteristics of the respiratory organs. Now, what is the first one? The large surface area to get enough oxygen. Second one, thin walls for easy diffusion and exchange of respiratory gases. And the third one, a rich blood supply for transporting respiratory gases. Okay, now let's see. With example of some animals, the respiration through air tubes. As I said, the different animals have different organs for the respiration. So the first one is through the air tubes. Okay, example you can see in the insects. Respiration through air tubes or trachea is a characteristic feature of insects. Tracheal opening you can see over here is called spiracles, which are located on the sides of the body of insects. The oxygen-rich air enters through the spiracles and reaches up to every cell through the tracheal system. Now moves to the animals that breathe through or respire through skin. One example given over here is an earthworm. In earthworms and leeches, exchange of gases takes place through skin. Their skin is always moist and is richly supplied with blood capillaries. The oxygen taken in mixes up with the hemoglobin present in the plasma of the blood and it circulates in the body. Let's deal with the respiration through gills. Now, gills are the respiratory organs in aquatic organisms like fishes, prawns and mussels. Water enters through the mouth of the fishes and you will see they flow to the gills. There are four gills on each side of the head. The blood capillaries are present in the gills, help in absorption of oxygen dissolved in water. The hemoglobin then transports oxygen to all parts of the body. Okay. This question is asked very frequently in examination why is the rate of breathing faster in aquatic animals than the terrestrial animals? I have already explained it at the beginning of this chapter, or I said this topic, that let's see the answer. Aquatic organisms breathe in dissolved oxygen from water. The amount of dissolved oxygen in water is very low as compared to the amount of oxygen present in air. Therefore, the rate of breathing of aquatic organism is fast as compared to that of terrestrial animals. Okay. Now next is the respiration through lungs. The respiratory organ in land animals such as amphibians, lizards, birds and humans are lungs. In the case of amphibians, we know that when they breathe in water, they breathe through their moist skin. Okay. Lungs have several alveoli. So what are these alveoli? Alveoli are tiny balloon-like air sacs that serves as the site for gaseous exchange. In my next video, I will deal with respiratory system in human. Namah Shivaya.